up in Kirsten, North Carolina, and I graduated from NC State with my bachelor's in nutrition science in 2007. I started as a microbiology major, like I said, but then switched to nutrition science because I feel like it gave me more of the foundation and background that I needed for where I wanted my career to go. After I graduated, I went to pharmacy school, and kind of during that time, I had a handful of internships. The biggest one, I think, was at PPD, which is a contract research organization here in the Triangle. They do research services for medical device, pharmaceutical, biotech companies. And I met a really influential mentor there who endorsed for me and gave me some really great experiences. Went to pharmacy school in Carolina. I still chair for the Wolfpack. and graduated in 2012 with my Doctor of Pharmacy degree. Then after that, I did a 2-year postdoctoral fellowship, and that was 1 year spent at UNC doing investigator-initiated oncology trials, and then the second year was actually back at PPD. And then during the summer, I spent at the Food and Drug Administration in DC, which is a really cool experience. So all of that kind of led to where I am now, which is at Perion Sciences. It's a very small biotech company in Durham that does pulmonary and ophthalmology research. I am an associate director at Perion, and I am, on one hand, in charge of the global day-to-day running of our clinical trials, which are right now in the United States and in Europe. Hopefully we'll branch out into, you know, Latin America and Australia soon. And that involves, you know, dealing with recruitment and talking to regulatory authorities and things like that. But on the other hand, I am the scientific lead for our pulmonary program. And there I work in writing protocols, looking at the data, looking at the clinical study report, kind of working with our physicians to answering medical questions that might come. You know, every day is different. I spend a lot of time in meetings, but I think each day and each meeting brings something new to me. Again, from trial recruitment to regulatory interactions to answering questions, working on protocol amendments, dealing with things that come up about study drug and getting it to where it needs to go. And actually, I just came back from Germany a couple of weeks ago. And we were there on an investigator meeting. We had an advisory board meeting, and that was really neat because we got to sit around the table with the brilliant minds in pulmonary disease and have them tell you what they think about your protocol and the way you design the study. But it's a fun job every day, and every day brings something new. I think high level, there's that buzzword, disease state management, you know, where you're not just looking at the prescriptions and the over-the-counter drugs and but you're also looking at changes that you can make in their diet that might preclude having to add on a medication. At my company right now specifically, one of our drugs that we're studying has to be taken with a high fat meal, as an example. So I worked recently on coming up with instructions for our patients who are participating in the study to say, you know, this is options for foods that you should eat with your medication so that it will work properly. And then at CVS, of course, I talk about nutrition all the time. Whether it's about drug interactions or weight loss or management of chronic diseases. So it really, nutrition has been kind of ingrained all through everything that I've done. You know, I think it goes back to, you don't just stop learning when you get out of school. You have to continually learn and continually grow. You know, I graduated from State in 2007 and Carolina in 2012, but I find myself still, you know, trying to learn business and finance and, you know, budgeting, things like that, that find their way into my job that I need to know how to do. So I continually try to grow and learn and develop and just increase my knowledge beyond the field where I work. I think what I am most proud of is when I was a freshman at State, I went to a career fair over somewhere, it's where the building's probably still here, and you know, it was probably juniors and seniors really ready for a job, but I got an internship at that career fair, kind of put myself out there with my resume, not a whole lot of experience because I was probably 18, and I got the internship, and I think it was that internship, which was even before PPD, that kind of propelled me towards, where I am now. I worked in the lab there, but it was really my experience there that made me say, okay, working in the lab is not what I want to do for the rest of my life. What are my other options? And it made me start exploring pharmacy and pharmaceutical industry and PPD. So from there, I went to PPD. Really, that was probably the thing I'm most proud of. There are ups and downs in your educational career and in your career in general. So I can't say that I would change anything that brought me to where I am, because as a result, I'm here and I'm happy here. So, I'm continually growing, developing, I make mistakes all the time, but there's nothing that I would change, I don't think. And I'm excited for the future. The biggest piece of advice I can give is to find a mentor or a champion, and that can be with someone who is doing graduate school or wants to further their education, or if you're getting a job right out of school. I think that it was most influential for me in helping me make decisions in my career and opening doors for me, introducing me to the right people. Have a mentor and someone who has been there before and has the experience, and they can give you some wise advice. I think that's the most important.